What's up, guys? My name is Dan Rodo, and I run a DIY YouTube channel called The Danocracy. Today, I'm hanging out at the ArtResin headquarters, and I'm gonna show you how to make a board game table using your favorite board game and some resin. Now, I recently just got a niece. Her name's Brooklyn. She's the sweetest little thing. I grew up playing Candyland, so I figured I wanna make her a board game table with Candyland. So for this, all you're gonna need is your favorite board game, and today is Candyland for me. And a table. So I went to IKEA, picked up a side table, but you can totally do this with a TV tray, an old table you might have that you wanna bring life back into. But we're gonna add a little twist to this. Because this is Candyland, I'm actually gonna incorporate real candy into our board game table just to give it a little more pop so Brooklyn wants to play Candyland when I come visit her. So let's head to the candy store, pick up some of our favorite candies, and we'll get started. Let's go. All right, step one is we have to get candy for our candy table. Now, I'm heading to a candy store right now. Luckily, I already know what I want to get. I'm going to do sprinkles on the top of the table, and I'm thinking I might do like a licorice or a ribbon candy, like around the outside. Step one, let's get the candy.
This is like the definition of Candyland right here. I like the round ones. Honestly, more than that. It's better to get too much. They were there on the floor when we got here. Maybe two more scoops. So, problem is they don't have the black licorice we're looking for. Off to the next store.
Wow. That was a lot of energy. And yeah, we now have all the ingredients for our candy table. Let's go make a Candyland table, baby! And we're back from our candy haul. This is what we got. Well, this stuff is for me. Thank you, ArtResin, for the corporate card. All right, we got our candy. Let me go get the other materials and we'll get started on our board game table made of real candy. Now that we've got all of our materials, it's time to get started. For step one, you wanna make sure that your tabletop is level before we work with any type of resin. For this, I've actually rested the tabletop on these little stilts that you can get actually from ArtResin in their accessory pack. And that's gonna hold our tabletop off of the bottom so when we pour resin, it actually can drip off the sides. Once that's off the tabletop, we're actually gonna take a bubble level and make sure that this is completely flat. And just like that, it is level. Now, because I know I'm gonna be doing a top coat of resin, a really great trick is to put a layer of painter's tape around the outside. Because when I do my top layer of resin, it's actually gonna spill over the sides, and as it starts to cure, you'll have these like ridges. Whereas if you have tape down, you can simply just pull off the tape, saving you the post-processing work. You'll notice when you do the top coat of resin that a lot of drips will form here. Now, this isn't a necessary thing, it's a really great trick to save you from having to sand once it's actually cured. Next, it's time for step two, and this is a little trick that I like to use whenever I'm working with candy, sprinkles in particular. Grab yourself some multi-purpose spray adhesive, because what you can do is you can spray a quick layer down, you can actually stick the board game down so it's held onto the tabletop, but it'll also hold your sprinkles in place and it won't have them move. What a lot of people do is they'll actually put resin down first and then sprinkles on top. The problem with that is sometimes the resin needs to settle and it'll actually move your sprinkles into places that you may not want it. So spray adhesive is key. Okay, now it's time to spray. Move our board. Just a thin layer over the entire thing. Well, you just sprayed it. Now you can place your board where you want it to go. Okay. Well, that's really sticky. Now that the board is down, we can now move over to our sprinkles and just grab a few in your hand and then just slowly just drop them on like that. Now, a lot of it will fall off, which is fine, but the base coat is there. When we put the resin down, we can actually put some sprinkles in at that point too. Oh, this looks so good. Look at this. I love me some good sprinkles. The board is down, the sprinkles are down. I'm now just gonna let it sit for about 10 minutes so the spray adhesive actually has time to grip onto the sprinkle and the table. Now that the tabletop has had time to settle, it's time to actually get rid of any extra sprinkles. And this is fun. Check this out. Oh, it actually worked great. Look at that. Yes, yes. Wow, the glue actually held really well. Wow, this looks so good. All right, now it's time to actually add our black licorice border. And so for that, we're just gonna use the spray adhesive as well. So we're gonna go around. Do a layer there. Let that sit for a little bit. While that's drying and getting a little bit more tacky, we're gonna get out our licorice. Now the great thing about licorice is that one side is actually flat, so it's gonna stick pretty flush to the side of our board. So let's go ahead and line one up, right up to the edge. All right, and just like that, the licorice is done. Oh, it looks so good. So good. Okay, so next up, we're actually gonna mix our resin for the top coat of our board game table. So it's important you put on some gloves for this. Now, if you guys haven't used ArtResin and it's your first time, the good thing about this is that it's measured by volume and not weight. So it's a very simple one-to-one mixture. Whatever I put here of the hardener or part A, you do the exact same amount as part B or the resin. Now, anytime I pour resin, I always use the ArtResin calculator, which is on their website. We have a 22 by 18 board, so you just plug that in, and this calculator will actually tell you how much resin you need so you're not over pouring and wasting resin in the long run. All right, now it's time to mix. When mixing resin, don't do it too fast, or you're gonna introduce air bubbles, and make sure you stir for a minimum of 2 minutes. 3 minutes. And make sure you stir for a minimum of 3 minutes. You gotta make sure it's fully incorporated into each other. Scrape the sides. Resin's been fully mixed. We also have a torch on standby because once we pour this, to pop the air bubbles right away, it's good to have a torch, barbecue lighter, anything like that. And the idea here is we're just gonna pour it right in the center, and since this is level, it's gonna self-level itself out, coating the entire thing. Let's do it. So I like to pour it a few inches from the board. I'm gonna pour right in the center, and you'll see it start to fan out. But you can also see all the bubbles that have been introduced from the mixing. Those will all be gone just when we hit it with the torch. But since it's not a perfect square, the resin's actually going to the side first before it hits the top and bottom. So you can use a spreader just like this and just help the resin get to the top farther corners. While the resin is still fanning out, we're actually gonna hit it with a torch really quick. And that's gonna pop any of the surface level bubbles. And whenever you're going over the sprinkles, you gotta move quick because you don't wanna melt them because essentially they're just like sugar balls. So don't hover in one spot for too long. That's looking really crystal clear. Dang. The resin's fanned out beautifully. We've popped all the bubbles, but it has carried some of the sprinkles out to over top of the black licorice, which is what we don't want. So I'm going in with a little brush, and I'm actually just sort of brushing the sprinkles back onto the board or off the board if it's giving me problems. Using the brush, you wanna make sure you get any of these drips so your licorice is fully coated and encased in resin. So before I leave this to settle overnight, I'm gonna put a box over top to prevent any dust or floaties from getting in our resin. And yeah, we'll come back tomorrow morning and this should be fully cured. And then we'll assemble the table. All right, see you guys in the morning. Day two, I am back at the ArtResin headquarters. This was here when I got here. It's supposed to be like a surprise to see the final piece. I'm really excited. It went pretty smooth yesterday, to be honest, which is great. So let's do the big reveal. 3, 2, 1. Okay. That is clean. Dang, that is nice. I think I'm gonna assemble this and see how it looks. But this is great, a Candyland candy board. We got sprinkles and licorice outlining it. Wow, not even a bubble, not one bubble. Okay, let's go assemble this. Ooh, actually, I almost forgot. The tape that I put on the back to prevent the drips from staying, we're gonna peel that off. And this is where you're actually gonna see the effect of this. Now, something to remember when you're doing this trick is you have to remove the tape from the 12 to 24 hour mark. That's when the resin is still sort of gummy and not fully, fully cured. If you leave it for anything longer than 24 hours, the resin might be too hard and then the tape will actually be stuck underneath. Look at this. Boom, boom. The drips just fall right off. Okay, drips are gone. Now it's time to build our table. All right, I've got the rest of my table here. I've got my pink drill. We're gonna start assembling. And hopefully it's not that, I mean, there's a lot of screws, like an odd amount of screws for something this big, but let's hope we don't get lost. All right, let's do this. Eight. What's freaking me out is we got one wooden dowel left. So I'm just hoping that's an extra and not just, I pick it up and just falls. All right, the big reveal. Ooh, baby! We got a nice Candyland board game table now. And just like that, we have made a Candyland table. The best part is that this board game won't get that wear and tear that normal board games get because it's protected under resin. And what's also even better is if, I don't know, kids drop the pieces on here or it scratches over time, just pour another layer of resin, brand new again. One, two, three, four. Oh, we're going to Nana's Nut House. Now guys, please go ahead and try this at home. You don't have to do this with Candyland. You can do it with Monopoly and maybe make it out of money, or you can do it with Clue and maybe toss in some, I don't know, question marks all around the board. This is totally a creative project and I would love to see what you guys create. Just be aware that some board games do need a sealant on top. If it's very like paper based or not very solid, the resin might seep in and then change the color. So look into that before you actually pour the resin on top. Have fun, create, be sure to tag ArtResin, tag me, Danocracy, and any of your pieces. I'd love to see them. And yeah, maybe I'll see you at the Frosted Palace. I'm just kidding, this is getting old, but this is sick.